Welcome to the online lecture of Computer Integrated Manufacturing in Automobile Industry. I am Milan Trivedi, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. We are actually discussing about chapter number 2, that is NC-CNC machine tools. In the earlier lectures, we had already understand the manual part programming method in which we are taking help of different G codes and M codes. If we are having a part drawing, then we can easily make the part program for that with the help of different G codes and M codes. But now let us understand one automatically programmed tool language that is called as APT. In order to understand this APT, first of all, let us discuss that why this APT language has been formed. The reason of the development of the APT language is that in the case of G code and M code, we need to remember the meaning of different G and M codes, right? Apart from that, we need to apply the logic that how does the different code will work. But in the case of APT, the work of programmer gets reduced to a greater extent. He just need to apply logic only. There is no separate need to remember the entire list of G codes and M codes. If it is not having the list of that G codes and M codes, then also he can or she can prepare the part program in a very easy way. So actually the entire setup of the processor has been changed with the advancement of this APT language, right? And in many of the countries, not in Asian countries, but in the European countries, they are using this APT language. If we look towards the format of the APT language, then it is having the geometric statements, motion statements, post-processor statements, and some basically additional statements. So let us understand the different formats first of all. First, there is a geometric statement. Geometric statements actually describes about the geometry of the particular part. Say for example, if you give the name of some point in an object, you can give it like as P0, you can name that point P0, then you just need to indicate that P0 is actually a point. After slash, you need to indicate the x, y and z coordinates. Say for example, x value is 1.0, y is 1.2 and z is 1.3. So in that you can write as point slash 1.0, 1.2, 1.3. Suppose you want to give the indication of a line, right? And you name it as a L1. So in processor, you can feed the command like L1 is actually a line which is passing through point P0 and P1. This P0 and P1 we need to predefine in the particular program, right? So this is how the geometry of the particular part has been written with the help of APT, right? In the case of G code and M code, we used to write, say for example, like this G00, X1.0, Y1.2, Z1.3. So the tool will rapidly travel to that particular coordinate. But in the case of APT, we just need to brief the different points or line. First of all, just we are with the help of point and line, we are actually giving the name or the particular identification to the part. The second is the motion statement, right? That how does the tool is required to be traveled? That is actually the motion statement. In the case of motion statement, we need to write it as motion slash description. Say for example, this from slash P0, that is from this point the tool is required to get started, right? Or it can be written as if we are having this 3 coordinate with us, we can also write that from this slash 0.0, 1.0, 2.0. So from that point the tool is required to be traveled. Then you can give the motion statement like this also, that go slash T0 L1 T0 PL1 T0 L2. What does this actually mean is that tool is required to go from L1 to PL1, means line 1 to this PL1 line. These lines we had already briefed with the help of the geometric statements, then from PL1 to L2. In this way the command is been written, right? You can also write it as this go forward, go back. That can be a case of motion slash description, means at what point this tool is required to be reached. If we need to give the forward command, then you can write it as go forward slash xyz coordinate value. Go backward, go back slash xyz coordinate value. Same way you can write it as go up, go down, go left, go right. In which direction the tool is required to be traveled, that has been mentioned in this motion part. And in the slash description part, you need to write the value of XYZ coordinates. The third command we need to have is about the post-processor statements that we were actually giving with the help of M codes, right? So the additional statement we require is about the spindle, that spindle should get started slash at what RPM, that spindle slash 600 RPM. So what does the processor will do? It will start the spindle and rotate it at 600 RPM. Then you can write it as feed rate slash 6.0. So FED RAT command is there for that. Slash 6 indicates it is having a 6 inches per minute of feed rate. Turret slash T2 means which tool is used from the turret, right? So it will load tool number 2 in the turret, right? So this is how the different post processor command work. For that we were having M codes in the case of manual part programming. And the last thing we require is about the auxiliary statement, right? If you are using the cutter, then what is the radius of that cutter? What is the diameter of that cutter? These are the actually the auxiliary statements. So you can indicate as cutter slash 0.25. So it will understand the diameter of that is a 0.25 quarter inch, right? So this is how the four different statement works. But you will understand that matter with the help of one particular example, right? So let us take one example in which we are writing a part program with the help of EPT language, right? So the program starts like this. Say we are having this particular part to manufacture. So from this corner point, we are just developing an imaginary axis, right? This is a, say for example, this is a X path, this is Y path. And the dimensions we are indicating on an axis part. Okay. Now the next step we are having is to indicate the different points and lines. So what we are actually doing is we are having these three lines basically. Bottom line I am indicating as just giving a nomenclature as L1, the slanting line as L2, and another line is given as L3. And apart from that, this L1 line is actually formed with the help of connection between point P0 and this point P2, and between this P2 we are having this even circle also. This circle we are naming it as, let's say, C1, and which is having a center of point P3. This center point we are just giving name as per our will, right? So the center point of this circle is P3. Okay, then this point we are naming it as a P4, again this particular point as P1. So this is how this entire point and lines are being indicated. Now let us understand the program. We are just giving part number. You can give any number. Then you need to indicate which operation you are doing. So this is the auxiliary statement, machine slash we are doing milling, right? Then you are indicating cutter diameter with the help of this auxiliary statement, cutter slash 0.5. Then you need to indicate the geometric statements, that P0 is actually a point which is passing through this XYZ coordinate. Then P1 is a point which is passing through this XYZ coordinate. Then again you are indicating P2, that is point. So what you are actually doing is you are indicating all the 5 points which you had described in our geometry, right? You are indicating to the controller that these are 5 points. And these are the coordinates value of that particular points. Once you are defining the points, you need to indicate the line and circles, right? So then we are having this three lines, that is, you need to be indicated. So what is L1? L1 is actually line which is passing through point P1 and P2. Then C1 is actually a circle which is having a center P3. That's why you can write it as C1 is equal to circle slash center P3, and the radius of that is 1, right? So in this way we are normally writing a geometry. Then after C1 we are having line L2, so you can write it as L2 is equal to line which is between P4 and left to tangent, and P1, P4 is left hand side and it is tangent to circle C1, right? This line is actually a tangent to C1, so you can write L2 as this, and L3 line is actually passing through point P1 and P4. This P4 and P1 is getting connected with the help of line L3, right? Once you are defining this, then you need to define a plane. PL1 is actually a plane which is there, in which we are having these 3 points P1, P2, P3. So what will happen, the tool will get indication in this plane the machine tool is required to be worked, right? Then you are starting the spindle. Let's say we are having to rotate that at 573 RPM. Then you are giving the feed rate command. That feed rate would be 5.39 inch per minute. Then you are starting the coolant with the help of this coolant slash on command. Then you need to start the operation. Right now you are just given the information of the geometry. Then you are given the different particular post-processor statements. Then you need to start the cutting. That how does the tool is required to move. So from P0 the tool is required to be moved. Then it required to go past L3 to PL1, then to L1. Then it should go up from L3 past L2, then go right from L2 and tangent to C1, then go forward CL on P2. So this is just a kind of geometrical drawing we are drawing, right? Just we are indicating that in this direction it is required to be moved and it should pass from this particular point. So that's a simple logic through which the tool is required to be moved. So then after go forward, it should pass from C1 on P2, go forward slash L1 past L3. Then it should, once this is done, you need to move right rapid, which means move rapidly. Once cutting is done, the cutting is completed, then it need to move rapidly and it should go to point P0, which is actually the starting point. Then it should stop the coolant flow and the program is finished. So this is a basic method to write the particular part program with the help of APT language. But you know, at least in the Gujarat board, this question is very rarely asked, right? But for your better understanding, the concept must be clear. And once you understand this thing very clearly, you will come to know that the programming with the help of APT language is very easy, because in this viewer does not require to remember the different G and the M codes, right? So that's all for the today's lecture.